Let's hope this thing lasts. Come on. No, it's just, I don't know what's up. It starts the stream, it stops the stream immediately. But it looks like we've got a solid 30 seconds going here. We got a 30 second streak. 30 whole seconds in a row of continuous streaming. I do have Comcast. How did you know? Is there some issue with Comcast today? Because it sure does feel like it. My internet's been slow all morning, and this stream has been like crazy. But okay, let's hope this stays on. Black screen again? What? What? It says it's fine. Can we have a good party without ice? Okay, all right. We're good. We're good for now. Let's everybody cross your fingers. Cross your legs too. If you know. It's really we need all the luck we can get today. Keep the stream alive. Oh, so it is, ma'am. What's up, baby? So it's a confirmed Comcast issue, huh? I pay like $80 a month for this internet. Yeah, well, okay. So for anybody that's just joined the stream, we were just having some stream issues there. But what I'm working on is this... I know, right? I know. Hey, dude... I'll deal with stream issues any day, internet issues, just the brain issues that, man, I don't know, it's tough. It's tough, tough, tough. Okay, so I'm drawing this, like, chain reel. Yeah. Yay, it's back. Okay, so this chain reel, I don't like the looks of this so far. I'm going to draw a new one. I'm gonna put it the other way. So it'll be like this sort of. I'll have like some kind of sides. Some chain. Maybe some chain like this, I don't know. So let's see what that looks like. Looks. Is that what it looked like? Wait, did I put a zero after this gate? Probably did. Yeah, gate two switch zero. Wait for it to repack the textures. It should work. Man, this takes forever. Ah, oh, I don't think it worked. Let's try it again. Ah, same problem as yesterday. Let me do some little hackery here real quick. This is my Lua script to repack textures. If last repack equals nil or now my size repack is greater than 15, then do it. Let's do that. Should reload the config. Now it's just going to repack textures multiple times, but come on. You're not drinking chocolate milk? What? There, it worked. Yay. So your question, I have a vector that holds my world tiles. I'm assuming that's a standard vector. And I loop through it to create sprites for them and position them. But they all have two or three extra pixels surrounding them when they should be side by side. No spacing. There's some kind of padding or something going on. No, there should not be any kind of default padding or anything like that built into Cocos 2DX. But how are you packing your how are you packing your textures? That's probably what I would look at first. Because Texture Packer can it shouldn't be powered by two as long as it's a default sprite with Cocos 2DX. I'm pretty sure this is a Texture Packer thing. Or if you're using what I need to know what kind of texture pack you're using. Let me show you what I'm talking about though. In Texture Packer, if you're using this, it's got you're not even packing the textures. Okay, well there goes that theory. What could possibly be making? That's crazy. Okay, maybe you could post your maybe you could post your just a bit of code where you create a single sprite. I could look at that. I don't know. Oh, it could be that. Jonah19's got a great suggestion to try there. You dereference a null pointer. That's all it is. Just a dereference null pointer, man. That's all. Yeah, besides being too... The edges of this thing are a little bit weak, but that's okay. Okay, so let's do a little more thickness here. In fact, I think I'm going to squish this all together a bit. Whoa. yeah. So, man, what was that? I just had an idea about it too. Oh, sometimes your content size can be different than your actual pixel size of your ping that you're loading. And I'm sure you've already checked this, but definitely double check if your ping file actually has padding built into it. It's 21. It's 21. Yeah, this thing's centered. Oh, they're just solid colors, totally. Huh, okay. What's up, Pro Tito? that's pretty good. It's a good width, good height. Okay, let's get some chains going into the ground then. So we need, let's do another layer below this thing where it's got some black. This chain's gonna be about this wide or so. We need a little bit more height on this thing here. Ah, yeah, that's much better. Giving it the depth. And a little more. Okay, so there's gonna be a chain. A chain is like gonna go over the top of this and down. See how it's looking so far? Nah, we'll just keep drawing. I want to see a big chain. Who's got exams? I kind of got an exam. Next week is Indy Cup. That's my exam. I got to have a fun game by next week. Funner. Much funner. Much more fun. That's kind of a cool chain. That's a cool chain. But that's the color I was thinking of. So make a little color palette for this chain. Nice. Yeah, right on. Indivisible got funded. The second one, let me see if it can load. Playing around with Unity. Is that the one you're talking about? Playing around with Unity? It's cool, man. Nice. Very voxely. Okay, so there it is. You got map width, map height, overworld generator, map width, map height, seed, generate map. Okay, looping over the map width and map height. There's 24 of them each. You got a string for what your sprite file is going to be. Tile grass, tile water, tile none. Yeah, this looks fine. Completely fine. And you're it's guaranteed that your images are 16 by 16, right? Okay, so here's what I would do. I would go in there. What I would check first is go inspect. Once you've created one of these sprites, go and inspect its texture. There's two things you want to expect. One is its content size. So you like once you've got a sprite like this. This is one of my sprites here. You would go sprite.getContentSize. Like that. And there's also, you also want to check this. This is really important too. You would go sprite.getTexture. Oh, maybe it's getTextureRect. Yeah, getTextureRect. So check out both those things. Because the texture rect is what is actually the texture's dimensions and offset within the texture. And also, and the content size is what Cocos 2DX expands it to be. So sometimes, if like, for example, when it's part of a sprite sheet, your texture rect is going to be that tiny bit of the sprite sheet or the texture that you're using, and the content size might include padding, it might include whatever. So that's what you want to check. If it is somehow got a bigger content size than your texture rect size, then you know there's something going on that's really weird there where it's blowing up your content size too much. Yeah. And if both of those are exactly the same size and they're correct, they're exactly 16 pixels and your image is exactly 16 pixels wide, then I don't know. It's kind of a real, that would be a real curiosity. All right, going back to making a little color palette for drawing a chain. Get like one highlight color as well. Whoa, that's really gray. Wow. All right. It's a chain reel that lifts up some moorings. So there's some underwater moorings here. And they're attached to chains, to some kind of mechanical system that you hit this switch thing and it releases these moorings from underwater and they float up and then you can step on them. So, like that, creates these mooring things. I need to add some ripples when you walk on water like this. That's basically it. What made you want to make game? You mean this game or games in general? Okay, so I'm starting to draw a chain. Oh, games in general? Just playing them. Yeah, playing games made me want to make games. I started playing games when I was like 9 years old or something like that. I think I got a Nintendo. I know. Yeah. Protito, it's true. It's true. But they all have their importance, you know? I think the first game I ever bought was Final Fantasy I, the very original. Yeah, RPGs really made me want to make games. 13.2? Well, there you go. There's your problem. Why are your images? Why are your images only 13 pixels when they should be 16, right? And why the heck do they have a 0.266666 going on? That should never happen. It's really crazy. I don't know. I would start looking at the ping file. What's up with that? Hover for Windows 95. Windows 95. Right? Totally. I want to know that too. But okay, so at least you've confirmed though. You've confirmed exactly what the problem is. See, that's a good question there, Jonah19. I was wondering that too, but CocoSUDX wouldn't squish the actual sprite's texture size ever. If you scale your image down to whatever, let's say you scale your scale to 0.5 or whatever, the image's texture size and its content size are always going to be exactly the same, but it just scales the image a little bit. So it should never ever change the actual texture size. It has something to do with how it loads. Yeah, no, it's not going to scale. It's not ever going to scale those down. It'll scale the actual rendered image, but it won't scale the content size or the textures rect. Drawing the chain time drawing. Time to draw some chains. Yeah. Good suggestion. Do I have a favorite indie dev studio? You fixed it? It was your res size? Oh, Jonah was right. Nice, Jonah. Hey, nice job, Woogie. Do I have a favorite indie dev studio? Oh, I was asked this a while ago. Maybe Cappy. Capybara Games. I don't know. I mean, I got a lot of games I'm really looking forward to. I'm not sure I would put one of them as my favorite though. I think everyone that's making an indie games is doing a good job. It's a very commendable task because it takes a long time and you barely make any money usually, and you spend so much time making games. So I don't know. I'm proud of everyone that makes games. Okay, so let's make another chain link. This time sideways. Yeah, I don't either. What's up, Artemis? Best way to learn Cocos 2DX? First of all, I'll go with your other question. Is there a difference between Cocos 2D and Cocos 2DX? Yes, there's a big difference. Cocos 2D is technically this thing called Cocos 2D iPhone, which actually turned into Cocos 2D Swift. In other words, it's basically just Cocos 2DX is the cross-platform C++ version of the old Cocos 2D for iPhone. They basically rewrote all the Objective-C code, which eventually was Swift. So they basically port they branched off, and one of them became Objective-C and only iOS and Mac, and Cocos 2DX became super duper cross-platform and C++. Best way to learn, I would start by getting it. I did write a book about it. About Cocos 2DX. You could maybe check that out or buy a book on it. There's a lot better books out there today. There's a lot of books that have been written. One's by Pact Publishing. But yeah, if you want to check out the book I wrote, it's a little bit out of date, but it's here at wizardfoo.com. Just search for Wizard Foo Cocos 2DX, and it should bring up my book. There's a lot of them here, but yeah. Yeah, well, it's way more portable, that's for sure. And it's way, you can publish it on so many platforms. Yeah, you're welcome, man. Not bad, not bad. This is a good, an okay start, I guess. This chain thing. There we go, starting to get a chain going. We'll do one more of these on the bottom. Yeah. Merge these, unmerge them. Yeah, looks okay. Let's see what that looks like in the game. Nice. Yes and no. Coco Studio X does have its own predefined game loop, which you need to hook your own game loop into. So you need to create your own game loop with the scheduling a method. Basically, you need to create a scene. This is stuff you'll learn when you just do some tutorials on Coco Studio X and you'll start learning. But basically, you need to create a scene or a layer or a node, something like that. Any kind of node, basically. And then you call the director's run scene method or whatever. And I think it's called run scene. Let's see what exactly that is. I've got a method called game run layer, which creates a basically. So this is what you do: you create a layer or a scene or whatever. You initialize it, and then sorry, I'm doing it totally different. But typically, what you do is you would call. Where does it? Hold on a sec. Game scene. There you go. This is all right. No, this is not even. This is also using another special method, but you just run a scene here. You call the director's run with scene. There it is. It's called run with scene. So once you've run a scene, then you've got a scene which is running, right? Which means that it's just attached to other layers. It's part of the Coco Studio X world. And then you also need to schedule something. So once you've got this scene or whatever that's running, you need to call schedule on that scene to schedule an update or something. So any kind of update method you want. And that creates a game loop right there for you. Makes sense. It should be it, once you check out the some Coco Studio X tutorials, it should be pretty apparent how that works. Yeah, that is looking okay. Now I just need to animate it. That black might have been a two-bit too much blackness though, and too neat. Yeah, they're a lot different. Yeah, Unity is totally different than Coco Studio X. Unity is by default, everything is an entity with components. It's actually very, very, it coded very well designed with Unity. And then Coco Studio X is kind of more do it yourself type thing. You really got to implement your own code to do stuff and I mean, not all of it, your sprites and everything that's basic is covered in Coco Studio X. It's just that you have to create your own entity component system. You have to, kind of create your own game engine based on Coco Studio X. Yeah, or use any foo. Nice. You did? Was that for your class? Thanks, man. Want to get another darker texture going? Change this hue, make it a little bit deeper. Yeah, for class, right. Okay. It's called game show. It's called game show. Gameshow.net, I think, is the address. Yeah, game show. I used to use Open Broadcaster, but it doesn't, as you guys are well aware, it doesn't have very good audio. At least on a Mac, it doesn't have very good audio. Okay, this is starting to look good. Hey, you're welcome, man. And yeah, we're starting ready to animate this now, I think, if this looks all right. See how it goes in the game. Yeah. Yeah, I wish it would work good. It works fine for on Mac for you? That's crazy. I wish I knew how to make it work fine on mine, but I tried every option a million times. I used it for months and it never ever. I tried millions of different settings options and I got to everything. Yep, that's the one I was using, multi-platform. What about just recording? No, I used OBS multi-platform. I believe it was multi-platform. What's up, Valveware? Hold on. So here, let's see, is there some way I can tell? This might, I hope this doesn't kill the stream. Oh, I just did it. I just opened Open Broadcaster and Game Show. Am I a fool? I'm such a fool, probably. Every time it upgraded, it said something about multi-platform. I don't know, is there some way I can tell here? I don't know. Oh, that is? All right. Okay. So we repack the textures. Actually just gotta get draw this chain animated. Yeah, this will work. I just want this blackness down here at the bottom to be less black and a little more dirt colored, I guess. Like the bubbles, cool. Right? That's another quote for Rocket Bunny's book. Right, so yeah, let's see if the blackness is less black, a little more brown. Right, yes. Yeah, that does look a little better. Okay, yeah, next thing is the animate. Sweet. Okay, so the chain, let's get the timeline up. Create a timeline. Yeah, it does look better, right? Just that little bit of not so black was your good touch. Okay, so we'll go down. Yeah, we can go one pixel at a time on this. Can it be triggered by ghost swords? No. This is meant to be a gate only for the top hat. The ghost swords, you know, they're made of like energy and stuff, so they're gonna have their own gate. It's gonna be something else. Draw on white? No, this is a transparent background. Is that what you're asking? This is just transparent here. Let me see. I can zoom in and show you. Oh, I can't. But I could put a background in here just to be gray. Yeah, there's a grid. Okay. Okay, so there's frame zero for the chain. There's frame one. Moved it down like one pixel. More of this is going to be visible. Frame two. Show me the invisible. It does kind of look, but it is kind of better to work with a not so white background. So right about this frame, I think the other this other chain is going to become visible, like right about there. Something like that. Right? Yeah. You know which is better? You mean the black versus the full black? Or are you talking about versus the transparent white versus this gray? All right, so the first frame we had. Two pixels a gap and then one pixel. Yeah, we need to keep going. Okay, so this is one more. Oh, the black stream. Nice. All right. Oh. Yeah, getting close. There's a couple more pixels until this thing's ready to match up with its other pixel thing. You like that color? I like more red too. Stealth game with lethal amounts of screen shake, huh? Every step is a screen shake. And it's a stealth game. What are you, like a sumo ninja? That's what you should call it. You should call it sumo ninja. You're so heavy, it's really hard to be a ninja. Exponentially shakes more. It's like I don't need this fifth frame here. All right, ready to animate. What happened, Bafu? What you doing, buddy? Ooh, oh, I got something. This will be nice. One little pixel. One little pixel. A pixel right here on top of everything that creates a little bit of shadow. Wait. There, that's gonna be nice. Little shadow. Cool. Protito, I have one monitor, that's correct, but I have an iPad set up that I'm looking at the chat window on. Yeah, buddy. Bapu is self-aware. Okay, ready to try. Come on, let's see what it looks like. All right. So we got these all lined up. Yeah, that's the ultimate irony. You can't spell fail fish. Okay, make a single loop forever. Yeah, that kind of looks all right. It'd be nice if the drum in the middle though also did some rotation. Even the slightest rotation would be nice. Is there a failer way to fail? That's one, Rocket Bunny, that's one for your book right there. Is there a failure way to fail? There's not. At least you went with the ultimate fail, dude. That's the ultimate. Yeah, it looks nice and smooth, huh? I think the middle drum reel thing though would be nice if it rotated too. So we'll need two of these frames here. Oops. Yeah, definitely. It's kind of, I'm thinking it's like, it's just going like this. It's like going in one thing and out the other. So it's not really like it's coiling up on this reel thing. Let's see what that looks like with, let's see if we can get that and then switch it to that there and here. Oh, it almost works. Almost. It just needs. It needs one more frame. Dodge wheel, yeah, the highlight probably wouldn't change, but it kind of depends, right? This is a metallic substance, and I don't know, I'm kind of trying to it yeah, this might not be the right thing to do perfectly, but yeah, right? What does it need? What does it need? Maybe if it had a little bit of. All you need is love. Oh, Aslier, thank you, man. That's a good idea. I think I'm gonna start with actually just trying it out in the game first. You know, because sometimes things look weird in Photoshop, and then put in the game and they look all right. Yeah, it is. It is. Yeah, that's what I was when I was watching it too. I'm like, it's like it goes too fast. That's why I tried to make it every other frame, but it didn't really work. What if this was just a slower animation? Even there, it doesn't look that good. Yeah. It's like, no, yeah, okay. There's got to be a better solution than that. I like Aslier's suggestion there. But I guess it would be cool to see it in the game so far. So let's do that. Export render video. This needs to go in common gate to switch. And so getting it to running animation, here we go. To switch percent D, run it on. We want to repeat it a couple times. It's weird, huh? It sounds like you've watched a bunch of these videos then. Well, welcome to the live stream, Aslier. Am I saying your name right? Aslur? Aslier? Welcome to real life. Real life liveness. This animation is 0.6 long. And this thing, wait, let's go for oh, actually, I want to run this here. Oh, I'm in the wrong place. Oh, yeah. This needs a. This, where does this get activated? The actual. There's the switch and then there's the gate. Oh, here it is. Here's the gate part, or the switch part. Yeah, right, Jonah. Yeah, before take. Think there's about a 0.618 delay there. right, so it's a, we're doing about 1.68 seconds long. Kind of want to repeat this like three times. That would be 1.2, 1.8. Yeah, three times would be about right. These are kind of magic numbers though. Badness. Oh no. Damn. What's RNG? Really? Yeah. Oh, that was cool. I love seeing it animated. It's all kind of a little too dark, I think, though. Oh, random number generator? Rocket Bunny, I think OBS is good for Windows. See, that kind of actually worked. It looked okay. In the game, it looks okay. And then... yeah. This whole thing is just a tad bit dark. Thanks for the follow. Yeah, the chain sound is off. Huh? I haven't even checked it yet. Yeah, it needs to start right away rather than waiting. I'm thinking like a 2 second delay there, and then maybe run it at least another four times. Yeah, it's a big. A silver chain? Possibly. Whoops. Yeah, I don't know if it does it necessarily need to look any brighter? Not necessarily. It probably should have a shadow. Oh, it's supposed to have a shadow. Yeah. Or the drum brown? Cool, at least the sound's lined up now. I think, let's see it one more time. Ooh, plant life. That's a cool thought. Okay, I'm listening to the sound. Yeah, that's cool. The motion, the sound, it's working. Yeah, let's try lightening up that chain. Just the chain. Brighten it up. Ooh, shrooms on the wood, yeah. Glowing shrooms. Wait, I don't know if that repacked or if it copied the textures after it repacked. Hopefully it did that time. Okay, so if I had some grass or some shrooms or something, yeah, let's do a shroom coming off this. Let's do a sort of a light tan. Cool. Yeah, it's good enough. It's good enough for now. What I want to do next is start on a different sort of look for this kind of screen. Check in these files. Yeah, good enough for now. Yeah. Right? Can't spend all the whole stream just drawing that. Even though I usually do spend the whole stream doing something like that, as simple as that. We want this. Oh, I gotta get rid of this. Put away the graphics tablet. Let's get to code mode. Code mode. I wanna do a cool scene. I wanna make this whole thing. This whole scene for the gate looks sweet. Better. Oops. A playthrough? Yeah, I could do a playthrough. It's broken. I know I played it just last night, and I know there's a lot of stuff that's broken and a lot of stuff that I want to change. But yeah, I'll do a playthrough, and that'll be a good thing anyways to get kind of familiar with what needs to be done before next Thursday with the Indy Cup. Yeah. Okay, cool. We got those added to that. Okay, let's play. Let's play a little bit. You the best, Jot Bapu. Okay, so I'm gonna play. Alright, so what should the world seed be? First person to do six letter. To give me a six letter, exactly six letters, has to be all letters. Yep, C time. Herman! Alright, Herman it is. Nice boogie, quick on the draw. I'm playing with my Xbox controller today because I love the way it. Oh, all great suggestions. I like the no beer one. It makes me want a beer, even though it says no beer. Thanks, Rocket Bunny. I'll play with headphones on. Really got to work on the timing of these dialogues. Needs to be more natural. What happens if we don't get the sword? I don't want to not. I want to play without the sword. That's too hardcore. Nice, Lime Studios, I'm glad. Let's hope this first guy doesn't kill me. This dialogue right here is also, whoa. This dialogue should not be playing while I'm fighting an enemy. That's a bug. He did. There's gonna be a story element around that, around Jib fighting to try and save you, sort of, and. Right? Whoa, what happened here? Oh! Hornrang's missing input component. Hold on, this is an easy fix. Hornrang, input. Yeah, the new that first mini boss is cool, right? Oh, wait, we want to go. Oh, that was weird. It wouldn't let me click it. Herman! I'll take the Herman! What the heck? That was weird. That was funny. Mini bosses in a row, huh? You should probably wait a second before you get this one. Yay! We got the top hat. So, what's really different about the whole world now is it's got gates, so I will not be able to actually get past a certain point in some places. Okay, there's a bug here, the floor is gone. I don't know why. No floor in that room. What? We already did this. Wait, is the stream still going? Yeah, it's getting there. It's getting there. Just going straight to the left. What's to the left? What's over here? Oh, look at this. Oh, that's a switch. Ah, threw my top hat away, but that's. Oh, this is great. I know. Yeah, too many bugs. But look at this. This is what we wanted to. This is what we just made today. Let's test it out. Yeah! Oh, that was awesome! It worked. All I need now is some ripples and stuff when you step on this water, and it will look cool. Let's see if we can get back, though. Oh, yeah, you can. Nice! Yes! Oh, I love these gates! Gates are sweet! Yeah, that was awesome. I'm glad. You know, at least that functionally works. Yeah, BC Warrior! BC Warrior time. What do we got? Come on, we gotta find a level entrance at least. I'm just in the. Oh, whoa, what? Here's another bug. It drew the refill tile underneath the water and in an area where there's a river. Okay, I don't even want to write this stuff down though right now. I'm just going to play the game. Just remember the bugs. I'm totally going to remember all these. And that was kind of cool how the switch was in the water, right? Doesn't look intuitive? Well, true. Maybe there's a better way to do that. I wonder if I started. I did not start with the party cup. Oh, and it's not doing the lens wander for me. That's weird. There's another mini boss. Yeah, get Jib. Attack Jib. Not me. Yeah, he's totally going for Jib. This is great. Ah. It's guy needs some sound effects too. Some like squishy noises and stuff. I like how this guy builds up some momentum. It definitely adds a really nice gameplay element to have Jib kind of in the action of fighting stuff and enemies able to actually... Oh, that was kind of cool. I got a this reward. And this reward. Oh, yeah, Lime Studios, good idea. Yeah, the first time you come across a gate, Jib can go scan it or something. Right. Yeah. Oh, you think it's better without? Yeah, I'm okay having at least a subtle hint though. Maybe like some kind of something really subtle. Like maybe Jib just says something on that screen, like I don't know. What's up, Kofez? Wait, I got a feeling that... Whoa, oh, dude. What was that? Come on, give me some health. No health. Yay! Yeah? A horrible pun. Yeah, they're not able to be knocked back at all. But they probably should, at least a little, you know? All these little tiny adjustments, these are quick things to change. That's cool. You know, quick bug fixes are awesome. Oh hey, look at this, what do we got? Bugs. Switch way should we go? This is level 7? Oh man, this might be hard. I don't know how I even got in here. Use the 3 version. Yeah, Artemis, use 3.9. Ah, text is bad for... Yes, I agree, Irakoken. What's that, Jonah19? What's that link you just sent over? I know, let's see what happens playing level 7 with only 3 hearts and enemies with way more health and everything. Whoa, this is tough for sure. There's a lot of these. What happened to Jib? Where'd he go? Jib's lost. Bug! That's it? No reward? Teaching without teaching. I like the sounds of this, and I do agree that it's more Zelda. Zelda is... What's so great about Zelda is it allows you to explore. It's a very exploration-y type of game, you know? It's very rewarding. Oh, did that just appear? Already there. Jib's dead. Oh, Jib's back though. Where'd he come from? Yeah. Jib, where'd you go? You're here? You're not here? Come on, buddy. I need you. I actually do need you. I can't go on without you, Jib. So another thing about level 7 is that it's going to be really big. So... Should I try going this way? Oh, that's the start. You're a wizard, Harry. Hmm. What? Oh, another room. No reward. Oh, he said you're a hairy wizard. They said you're a wizard, Harry. Don't kill me! Don't kill me! I promise I'm here just on peaceful terms. I'm here to negotiate. Did you see the white flag? I am my leader. Take me to your leader. Oh. Oh, hey, now it's got the screen. The screen's actually moving now. Okay, so now we can at least see the game with the screen moving. That's cool. There's gotta be an item in here. Nice playing with the Xbox controller. It's got some really good action. I don't know what happens to Jim. He's not getting stuck on. It's like maybe he's still trying to scan something. Should the spiders walk on water? Was there any spiders there? Oh, there's a door. Jib somehow? Bombs! Alright. Still looking for the purple key. The light being off in some of these rooms. It's kind of weird, but it's actually kind of nice. It's cool to see the game, you know, doing a little bit of different lighting. I can make that better. Jib just suddenly comes on the scene. Yeah, cool. Yeah, I made the screen movement more subtle last night. It really, really helped. Yeah, cool, J2. Good call. Good call. For sure. He's definitely doing something weird. When you die, you can buy an extra life for a whole bunch of coins, but they're a lot harder to find in that game mode. Right. I like that, Pedro. So what's... Okay, we got the key in this room. Oh, the map's broken. The map is just completely broken except for the bottom. Whoa! We need some purple doors. Where'd they go? There's maybe one here. Ah! This is a cool room. I like this one. Oh, perma-normal death mode? Hey, what's up, Peen Wally? Synth, if target not looking. Okay, this is an easy fix. If target not looking, synth. Target. If target none, target nearest friend. If target near. This should be if target any. That one's got an if target any, if target any. Target any. Oh, it's probably this one here. If target any. Yeah. Nice. Right? Yeah, I hope so. I hope they're like, oh my god, what's up? The world's falling away. Let's start the game again. Lots of little bugs to get cleaned up for next week, that's for sure. So we should have the... I don't know how many keys we got. Hopefully we got the same amount of keys. Oh, you know what? It probably didn't save. Oh, that sucks. Because it crashed. Yeah, we don't have the purple key. Alright, we need the purple key. What's that you shared there, Rocket Bunny? Oops. See, that was supposed to be a hidden chest. I think. Oh, that's just the bombs. Where's that purple key again? So hopefully this synth works now. Cool, I'm glad. It needs a good transition at least, you know, like if it, one room is darker, you know, it needs a transition between the two different lighting effects. It's a red door. Right? Yes. Definitely my favorite kind of bug, too. Uber expensive item in the shop increases JIP scanning speed. Yeah! I'm pretty sure there's gonna be some kind of item like that for sure. Whether it's at the shop. Oh! Well. I think that's about it for today's playthrough. Let me see. I'll work on fixing this bug for a minute. I love it when the code writes itself. Oh wait, that's never happened to me. The entire world exists in memory, but only the current screen is what is created as far as sprites go and stuff. That's awesome, Lime. Yeah. What's shaking like crazy? Okay, what do we got here? Target not looking. Wow. Okay, I already checked to make sure that target not looking. Wait, is this? Yeah, it is synth. Target. There's only two places this is ever used, and one of them checks if target any, and the other checks if target any. So it must not be. Oh. It could be that maybe the synth is targeted jib, and then target not looking doesn't work with jib. That's what I'm guessing this problem is. Yeah, you're welcome. Yeah, I'll definitely be doing more playthroughs over the next few days because, you know, I gotta be you know, getting it ready for next week for the Indy Cup. Nice. Okay, so an AI system. Gotta crush a few bugs a day. Yeah, Pedro, I'm gonna update the alpha release. It may be that I have to spend as much time as I can getting the game ready for Indy Cup, and then I might have to do the alpha release update, like, you know, later that weekend or the next week or something like that. But I will definitely do an alpha update because I already promised some you guys and also a few YouTubers that there would be an update and stuff like that. So yeah, there's definitely going to be an alpha update. So you guys will be able to play this pretty soon. Okay. Protito, yes. The lights are entirely shader-based. CocoSuniX does have this concept called a light node, but I'm not using light nodes. There was one guy that mailed me that's actually had over 100,000 subscribers. I was pretty stoked. And then another guy had like 5,000 subscribers. I forget their names. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what their names are, but they'll be doing videos, and then I could look them up on my list, but I just don't want to get into that right now. Oh, not mood jib. We want to go to the behave system. Target align. Target is not looking. Here we go. Oh, this never returns. This is supposed to return a value here. Oh, default break. Oh. Yeah, yeah. Okay, so this is the problem right here. Jib. Poo-doo-poo. Oh, right? Pootie pie. Ah, I said it right? Pootie pie? Nice. Pedro, dude. All right, Pete Wally. See you, man. Yeah. PewDiePie has way more I think this is the problem. This guy needs to put return false here. So what's happened there is if Jib was the target of the synth, then it could fall through. It would, because Jib doesn't necessarily have a last compositor, and so it would fall through to this default and then break and then return an error. So I think this is okay now. I'm gonna put the player. Wait, what area is this? Creating area 257. I'm gonna warp the player to there because I don't want to have to go all the way back again. Oh, wait. That's not it. It's this one. Yeah, I finally said it right. Yeah. Yeah, see you, Lime Studios. Good luck with class and everything. Oh. Okay. Well, it didn't crash on the synth, but it did crash on the freezing gas. But that's an easy one to fix. Freezing gas needs input attributes. Input allow it. Yay! Oh, dude, that was funny. Oh, these guys are tough. Two of them. Freezing gas target timers. Target timers. Oh, it was so close. Algebra exam? Kofez, are you talking about all this? This is an AI behavior tree. It's something you should, that's something for your homework or something, you know. Check that out. Check out, look up on the internet, look up behavior trees. This is what these are. They basically run an AI without any code. So basically this is, it's kind of a script. So it's kind of code, but it's not really. I don't ever have to write any actual code to write an AI. It's just all here in its behavior tree. No, Geno 19, it's not gonna be the freezing gas depending on the synth being. Yeah, it's not gonna be that. It's gonna be something with do with target timers. What the heck is target timers? K behavior timers, set target timers. Okay. And EDI target. Okay, so it's probably that it's in freezing gas. Let's look at freezing gas's behavior, which is this thing. Okay. If timer begin, if timer end, if target any, here it is. No, wait. No, this should target nearest friend and then set target timers. Oh, once again, it could be that freezing gas is trying to target Jib. Yes, Artemis. Yeah, the behavior tree is parsed into just some integer values and stuff, and these integer values are being ran right here in the code. See? So like it does, you know, it checks the subtypes and types and then runs actions based on whatever, you know. So it's not actually, yeah, it's sort of, it's not quite code. It's almost both code and data. Oh, here it is. It's checking if the target's input component is empty before it returns true here. I'm just going to make it return true no matter what. So if it has a target, it's going to be okay. All it needs to do is just have a target instead of requiring the target to have an input component. Yeah, Artemis, yep. Thanks, Boogie. Yeah, I wrote the parser. It's called Valtree, and then I released Valtree on GitHub. So there you go. I really love Valtree. I've been using Valtree now for, you know, for this whole project. But I just recently, a few months ago, I put Valtree on GitHub, and it's gotten better since then. So Mars of Power helped make it better. Wait, we need some freezing gas. Come on. Do the freezing gas, dude. There's some freezing gas. There's another one. Yeah, I do think it's working okay now. Cool. Return true no matter what. Even if it fails, return true. Oh, wait. Is there a joke here? Is that a song? Is that a song lyric? Alright, so yeah, that's it for today's stream. Did some cool stuff today. Got this whole chain thing working. Did a playthrough. Pretty stoked. It is a song. Is it like bytecode? Sort of. It sort of is, Artemis. It kind of is, because essentially it's reading all of these into integers. So yeah, this kind of creates a bytecode. So a sequence is a byte. Timer's a byte, sort of. You know, yeah, it's kind of like that. So yeah, see you guys. Have a great night. I don't know what I'll be working on tomorrow, but I'll be back at Wizard 30 to work on Songbringer again tomorrow. So anyways, thank you all for watching. Hope you have a great night, and peace out. Have a good one.